and welcome to Living Supernaturally. This week we've been looking at a new series called Show and Tell, and today is day four. And in Show and Tell, we're looking at some everyday objects and how they point to some deeper truth in Scripture. And today we are going to look at the deodorant, a deo, and it dispels fresh fragrance, and it dispels, diffuses good fragrance, and it dispels bad odor. So it's a deodorant. It introduces a fresh fragrance to the very atmosphere. It's all nice, and it's smelling nice right now. And it takes away any bad odor. Maybe, you know, as sportsmen, you sweat a lot and there's body odor, it just takes it away. It introduces a new fragrance very quietly into the atmosphere. So it doesn't really make an announcement. A person who wears it, if that person just walks into that room, and you know that there is a nice, pleasant aroma, right? 2 Corinthians 2 and verses 14 to 16. It goes like this. Now thanks be to God, who always leads us in triumph in Christ, and through us diffuses the fragrance of His knowledge in every place. For we are to God the fragrance of Christ among those who are being saved and among those who are perishing. To the one, we are the aroma of death leading to death, and to the one, the aroma of life leading to life. And who is sufficient for these things? In other words, God is saying, the Lord is looking to us and He's saying, you are the aroma of Christ. In other words, we are the deos, we are the deodorants, you and I. And as we walk into different environments, we are the aroma of Christ among those who are being saved, who have made a choice to receive Jesus as their Savior, and to those who are yet to make that choice. We are the aroma of Christ. And we are also the aroma of life itself, the fullness of life, the God kind of life, which the Bible calls as Zoe. So we are this aroma when we walk into a room, when we walk into different spheres of influence. Maybe it's your college, maybe it's your family, maybe it's our office, ministry, wherever we are the aroma of Christ. So we bring the fragrance, and this is what we bring. We bring the fragrance of His knowledge into every place. The knowledge of Christ, the knowledge of the person of Lord Jesus, the knowledge of salvation through faith in Christ, the knowledge of a changed destiny, the knowledge of victory over sin, the knowledge of freedom and redemption. We are the fragrance of that knowledge of Christ in different scenarios. So when we walk into a room, we bring the fragrance of the knowledge of Christ. How do we do that? With our behavior. The way we behave, the things that we do, our actions, our reactions, our responses. And the way we converse, our conversations with people. What is our conversation? What are the words like? What are the things that we're talking about? What are our jokes like? Our reactions, our responses to people, our compassion, and our intentional sharing of Christ and His work on the cross. So we bring the knowledge, the fragrance of Christ, the aroma of life into every place. So today, when you walk into your office or when you walk into your classroom, just remember that you are the fragrance of the knowledge of Christ. God looks to you. Now, to God, we are this. Let's pray and thank God. Father, we thank you for this identity, God, that you look to us and you say that we are the aroma of Christ. In every place, we are the aroma of the knowledge of Christ. And this is what we are. This is who we are to you when you look at us, God. And thank you for this purpose. Thank you for this identity, God, that in the way we live, the way we conduct, through our conversations, God, and everything that we do and say, that we can bring the sweet-smelling fragrance of Christ, of the knowledge of Christ in every place. We thank you for doing this. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Thank you for tuning in to Living Supernaturally. For more resources to strengthen your spiritual walk, please visit apcwo.org.